July 12, 1958. Because it's the 50th anniversary of that wonderful day, I'm fortunate enough to be able to put the pictures where other people can see them. The album itself is rather soiled because I've been carrying it from place to place over the past 50 years. Joined in marriage, this day, July 12, 1958, the bride, Clara West McNerney, and the groom, Vincent Joseph Doyle. The ceremony at St. Titus Church, Titusville, Pennsylvania. The clergyman, Right Reverend Monsignor William Sullivan, and the attendants, James B. Doyle, Jr., Thomas F. Melody, Jeremy C. McNerney, Margaret M. McNerney, and Mary A. Phillips. The missing bridesmaid was Pat Bounds Corcoran, who unfortunately at the 11th hour was not able to come from Baltimore to Titusville. The morning of the wedding. My sister, Margaret, who was my maid of honor, is helping arrange my veil. I had gotten the dress and veil and the bridesmaids' dresses in Philadelphia, where I was teaching and where I met Vince. My dress was a light white material, organdy, I think. Very summery. Margaret's dress was white organdy also with a blue satin sash. I like the hats for the bridesmaid. I think it was my mother's suggestion, and I think it's similar to what she had in her wedding. This is the formal bride's picture. It was taken in the living room of my parents' home. In those days, the photographer came to the house, went with you to the church, and then on to the reception. Here I am with Margaret and my good friend Mary Phillips. The flowers we carried were Shasta daisies, one of my mother's favorite flowers. Again, we're in the family home. This is the house that I was raised in. It had been my grandparents' home, so my mother was raised there too. It has many, many, many happy memories. That morning, Saturday, July 12, 1958, the weather was cloudy and dark. As we arrived at the church, it sprinkled. Fortunately, by the end of the day, the sun was shining brilliantly, and it was a beautiful summer afternoon. In this picture, my brother Bill is helping me from the car into the church. My father is behind me, and Mary Phillips is turning to speak to Bob Sauber, her boyfriend and subsequently husband, and of course my sister Margaret is there. If you can see the car, it was an Edsel. The family car at the time just wasn't up to such an elegant affair as a wedding. So my father rented the latest and greatest thing available, the Edsel. The Edsel didn't turn out to be the great success that the Ford company had hoped for, but it did get us to the church and back, and fortunately, the marriage lasted much longer than the Edsel itself. Now we're in the vestibule of St. Titus Church. My brother Bill, my mother, my sister, and Mary Sauber securing my veil, which, by the way, didn't stay secured. On the way out of the church after the wedding, it bounced off my head. There was a slight pause at this point. Mr. and Mrs. Doyle, Vince's parents, were waiting at the hotel. There was a misunderstanding. We thought they were coming to the church with Vince's aunt and uncle, the Landys. When we discovered that they weren't at the church, my brother Bron rose to the occasion and swiftly went to pick them up and bring them to the church. Here we have the ushers. Tom Melody, Vince's cousin, and my youngest brother, Jerry McNerney. They're rolling down the traditional white runner. The bridal party would walk up to the altar on this runner. I don't think that tradition has continued on, and I'm not sure how it started, although I suspect it was to keep the bride's dress clean. Tom Melody was the first guest to arrive in Titusville for the wedding. And for those of us who knew and loved him, this was no surprise. He was very punctual. My brother Jerry was in the wedding party because he was the brother that Vince knew the best. I'm not sure why that was. Here, my father is taking me down the aisle. It was difficult for Dad to walk down the aisle in public. He rose to the occasion very well, but I know it was an effort for him to do it. He had been up the night before in the kitchen drinking postum, trying to relax and be ready for this big occasion. There were about 350 people invited to the wedding, which was quite large for Titusville. Things were simpler then, so this was quite an occasion. Here we are at the actual wedding mass. Monsignor is saying the mass. He's the celebrant. The older boys were Bob Felton, who lived across the street and is still a good friend of the family. And I think the other altar server is our cousin, John Beale, who is now Father John Beale. Off to the right, you will see my brother Stephen, who at the time was a seminarian himself, getting ready to go to the North American College in Rome to study. Looking at the congregation, you'll notice that all of the women are wearing hats. This was the tradition in the 1950s and lasted at least until Vatican II when changes were made. The wedding ceremony itself. The best man, Vince's brother Jim, and my sister Margaret look a little bit solemn, but I definitely recall how much at ease I was and how relaxed both Vince and I were on such a happy occasion. Here we have Mr. and Mrs. Vincent Doyle. How I love the sound of that. We had met as new teachers in Bear Junior High in South Philadelphia in the fall of 1954. Vince was just back from Korea, and I first saw him in the faculty lunchroom, where it was pointed out to me that he was a Villanova graduate, just out of the service, Catholic, and single. Presenting Mr. and Mrs. Vincent Doyle. Leaving the church, walking down the center aisle, certainly one of the happiest times of my life. You can see that our wedding party, Jim Doyle, the best man, looking at Vince and he looking at Jim, his brother, and my sister watching me as we leave. Outside of the church, we formed a reception line. You can see my father standing to the left, looking a bit solemn, my brother Bill. Vince and I were greeting. I see some people from West Philadelphia there, Babs and Miriam and Dick Kelly. I think I see some of our little cousins, the McNerney girls, and Beals maybe. I see my cousin, Wager, and to the right we have Mary Ellen Landy, and then at the very right, my mother. Here are more of the people who were at the wedding. We have Anne Mary Farley on the left, and I don't know who the next woman was. Then Dr. O'Hare, who came from Corey and gave us all our shots when we were little. I see Kay Canada, Jane Canada's sister, and coming center toward us, toward the camera, is Mrs. Jameson, who lived on the corner and whose husband was the general practitioner that delivered all of us. In the front, in the middle, toward the right, we have Vince's parents and his aunt and uncle, Aunt Anna and Uncle Tom. Aunt Anna and Mrs. Doyle were sisters. Here we are, back in the Edsel, on our way to the reception. The car was probably decorated, but I can't remember the details. I'm sure, though, with the Doyle family and the McNerney family, that something was done, maybe some tin cans or that kind of thing. Here's one of my favorite pictures, Jim Doyle and Vince, brothers. Behind them is the portrait of Colonel Edwin L. Drake. The hotel was named after Colonel Drake. He is the man who first was able to drill and bring oil up out of the ground and started the oil industry in the world. That was in 1859. The hotel itself was quite nice at those days. The out-of-town guests stayed there, and we had the wedding reception there. Unfortunately, times have changed, and it's now been taken down, and there is a CVS at that spot. I don't think that's progress, but that's the way it is. The reception began in the cocktail lounge at the hotel, appropriately called The Well. My father had wanted to have a champagne fountain, and although he wasn't able to arrange it for my wedding, he was able to do it when my sister Margaret married a year later. In this picture, we have the Lombards from Corey, and me and Vince. On the very right, I recognize Miss McCabe, a lifelong friend from Titusville. Here we have the head table and the toast. Vince's brother, Jim, I'm sure, gave the toast. I don't remember the specifics. Things were, as I said before, simpler in those days. At the table, we have Mary Sauber, Father Richard Buttrin, Vince and me, Monsignor Sullivan, my sister, and Father Martin, who came from Erie. I think he was in charge of the seminary that my brother Stephen was attending. And Jim Doyle and our bachelor cousin, Tom Melody. The menu, I think, was probably chicken a la king and peas and something nice that was pretty standard in those days. My mother made all the arrangements for the wedding with my wholehearted agreement, since I was in Philadelphia for the year and she was actually there in Titusville to do the phoning and all. And here we have the wedding couple sharing their first meal. Every year afterward, on our anniversary, we would go to a different restaurant for dinner. It's something that we enjoyed and looked forward to. Of course, there were many different types of restaurants and escapades. I remember one time when we were downtown in Washington and the restaurant was on the second floor and the firemen arrived. We asked our waitress if we should leave, and she said, oh no, it's just something in the kitchen. So we didn't leave, we went right on with dinner. Probably the best anniversary was 1983, our 25th, when we went to Ireland for our first visit there. Behind me is Peggy Gelott Brummagen, a classmate from high school. I remember her saying that if she had known how much fun the reception was going to be, she'd insisted that her husband would come. Oh, yes, and you can see that Vince is smoking. Actually, we both were smoking at that time. That changed later on. Now we have the head table. I think you know the people who are there. You might wonder why my father is at the head table. He was supposed to be with the smaller table parents of the bride and groom, but he saw an empty space because we were short of a bridesmaid, and he sat himself down, and we were all very much in agreement with that. Mary Sauber is beckoning to, excuse me, Mary Phillips, later Mary Sauber, is beckoning to Bob Sauber, who was seated at the table behind. Also, in the far left corner, behind Father Buttrin, you can see another high school classmate, Perkshaw Fleming. Our class was small. There were only 12 in high school, 10 girls, so each one is very important. And here we have the parents of the bride and groom, with the father of the bride missing. Mrs. Doyle never liked this picture, and I think it's pretty obvious why, since it, but I think it must have been her son that selected it for the album. She was a good sport. Mr. Doyle looked handsome. If you notice, he's dressed as the wedding party in a formal tuxedo. A lovely gentleman. I was very fortunate with my mother-in-law and father-in-law. Here we are cutting the cake. You notice that there are Shasta daisies as the decoration. I don't think we had the traditional bride and groom. I don't see it there. I don't remember the cake specifically, but I'm sure, considering the time and the place, that it must have been from Coburn's Bakery, which was a very good bakery in Titusville of many years standing. At that time, the cake was served and everybody had a piece there. You'll notice that we don't have frosting or cake all over our faces. The custom of feeding each other at the wedding reception had not yet come into vogue, something that I'm rather pleased about, actually. And here we have the whole wedding party. Tom, Jerry, Jim, Vince, me, Margaret, and Mary. In the foyer of the Colonel Drake Hotel in Titusville, Pennsylvania. If you look out behind Jerry, out the window, you'll see Thompson's drugstore marquee. Ebenezer Thompson lived right across from us on Perry Street. And the Thompson home was one corner and the McNerney on another corner. And later on, Mary and Bob Sauber were on one of the other corners, and the fourth corner had a church on it. Anyway, when you look at these pictures and see how things were, it brings back many happy memories. This is a nice picture of Mom and Dad, Vince and me, and his parents. Mr. and Mrs. Doyle came from Mount Carmel, Pennsylvania. They had been born and raised in the coal mining area. And when Vince was 13 and the mines closed, his father moved them to Philadelphia in order to work. But upon retirement, they returned back up to the coal mining section. My mother and father were born and raised in Titusville. They knew each other as children and then went off to different schools and didn't see each other for a while. But they met at a party in Rome, Italy. And that's where the romance began. And here we have my favorite picture in the album, Vince and me as we begin a new life together. We're ready to begin a new life. Once we leave the hotel and go back to the family home, get changed and head out on the honeymoon, we'll be sailing off into the sunset, little realizing that what is to follow will be even more wonderful than our dreams. This video is for you, Greg. Margaret, Kate, Tim, Jeremy. And Susan. Dad and I love you all. And I know that you love us.